We're just gonna go with it. All right, we're jumping right in, guys. This is episode 3 of The Wolf Among Us, titled, A Crooked Mile. That's what it's called, A Crooked Mile. The chat, A-Bomb, thank you for subscribing. Really quick, get that in here. Let's start this bitch. I'm so excited. If you guys haven't seen the previous two episodes,
used to be so simple.
Go watch them if you haven't.
Beginning, a middle, and an end. But ever since we moved to this awful city, everything's gotten so confused.
Look, I didn't kill anyone.
And I'm supposed to just believe you. Snow.
Dun.
I just want you to be careful. I almost lost you once, and...
I'm not yours to lose. I'm not going to be an errand girl for Crane anymore.
She looks like Holly.
It's not Holly. It's her sister, Lily.
She was hooking to pay down debt. Eventually, the only people she owed were at her work. You know, that shithole club.
Oh, titties!
My name is Nerissa.
Well, Nerissa, I've got some questions. The open arms.
Oh my god!
Oh man, the flashbacks.
What is it?
It's Crane.
The creepiness. I forgot how creepy that photo is. Holy shit. I forgot we were right here. We just found out Crane is the fucking freak. You know what, though? Let's be honest. Who else thinks that it's not Crane? It can't be Crane. Fucking creep.
Fucking creep. Spineless little fucking rat.
Crane? Ugh. God, you think you'd know a person. Bigby, you have to tell her.
I know.
I think it's someone else.
What's
I don't think it's actually
on?
Him.
What did you find up there? You know, other than the...
I just need to find Snow.
Why? What's going on?
Shit!
Crane's been...
Mad. Oh, God.
Everything's going to be fine, okay? It's going to be fine.
That perverted little fucker might be after Snow. I need to find her right now.
Okay, it's going to be okay. Where did you see her last? Did she say where she was going?
She took Holly to the business office to prepare for the funeral.
Lily's funeral?
Yeah.
How do you know?
I was just at the Trip Trap, and I heard Gren telling some folks about a funeral at the Buckingham Bridge.
Trip Trap? Are you drinking?
When?
Right now. They were on their way out.
Uh-oh.
Bigby!
Damn, Beast is drinking again. Oh no.
Wait.
You fucked up, Beauty. You done fucked up.
What?
Snow's been through a lot. There are things she doesn't talk about. Just please be careful when you tell her. And you should tell her.
What do you mean?
But
what are you trying to say?
You know how you felt when you saw that picture? Well, it's going to be much worse for her. Just remember that.
True. Okay, so we're going to the funeral. The Buckingham Bridge. Ooh, achievement unlocked. You guys can't see that, though. Oceanic Airlines. You gotta put your hard hat on, bro. This motherfucker, he don't give no shit. He don't need no hard hat. All right. This is creepy. Who has a funeral underneath the bridge? I guess it's because it's for a fable, so they're trying to hide it.
If you were here, then you were part of a very special.
Yo, Snow, it smells like shit down here.
Trusted and cared for. I won't offend you by claiming one day that the pain of losing Lily will.
Hopefully, she doesn't get mad.
I know as well as you that it will never subside.
Okay, she doesn't want me to interrupt.
That the memory of Lily will sustain as well.
Offering
and
table.
And it will, in time.
Let's look at the cards. Let's let her have her conversation with them.
I'll miss
and it is
worrying
in that spirit
about you.
That I'd like to talk
I'll
about
miss our fights.
What you've all been
I'll
so
miss
grateful
you.
To share with me.
Holly.
Your memories of her.
How's that?
How she could be stubborn and patient.
Now you will never die from indifference.
Though she carried a torch for the old ways.
Life.
For tradition.
Goodbye, sweetheart. Thanks for everything.
And most of all, it seems how...
I don't like that card as much. It's hard to fucking listen to him and her at the same time.
Big, bright, shining star in this shithole of a town. And I miss you already.
His thumb is in the way. How the fuck does he read it?
I know.
Ooh, ooh. Bottle of liquor, take it. Let's steal the rye whiskey.
And now we'll have our Billy go.
Moment of silence. Okay, cool. See? You let her have a talk, you let her get it all out. And now we're gonna go talk to Snow. I think. I don't wanna interrupt.
Bigby, is everything okay?
There we go, I waited.
No, not you.
Holly, it's...
He wasn't fucking invited.
Holly, wait.
He has no right to be here.
Uh-oh.
Not after what he did.
Holly, I'm sorry, but I had to come.
You throw my sister down the witching well, and you have the nerve to show your face here. After you lie, after you promise me.
Holly, wait, that was Crane, just Crane. He disposed of Lily's body before Bigby could do anything about it. I'm telling you the truth.
Don't cover for him.
It's true, bitch!
It wasn't his fault.
You can't tell me Bigby gives a shit about this.
Holly, this just isn't important right now. I need to talk
to Snow. Oh shit, that was the wrong thing to say.
Fucking bull.
That was rude as fuck.
Bigby cares, Holly.
Oops.
He's trying to help. And I'm sure he has a very good reason for being here.
I do,
but
I do.
This one isn't on him.
Why are you here anyway? And don't say it's because you care about this.
Everything okay?
I think I know who murdered your sister.
Who?
Maybe we should talk about this somewhere else.
What? No, I deserve to know.
I know, but this isn't the way to go about this.
I don't give a fuck about the way. I don't care about procedure. If anyone should be told, it's me. It's us, right now.
I came here to talk to Snow about this.
No, screw that. My sister's dead, and I don't give a shit who she looked like when it happened. It's not about her. It's about Lily.
Just tell us who it was.
Should I tell him?
Everyone, just stop. Bigby and I are going to have a little chat while everyone else gets back to the funeral.
People are freaking out.
What? I'm not just gonna sit here.
Please, I promise I will tell you what the hell is going on just as soon as I know there's something to tell, but just let us do our jobs first.
Yeah, cover up your titties while you're at it. It's gross.
No, you don't know how this must feel. You have no idea. Don't fuck anything up. Don't bother anybody. And when the first sign of trouble comes, and it will come because you're a goddamn walking trap for it, I want you the fuck out of here. You hear me?
I just want to get Lily's killer, Holly. Nothing more.
Let's just continue, okay?
This is such total fucking bullshit.
Damn,
let's go,
she
Holly.
Mad.
It's your turn to talk.
This fucking guy. She likes showing her teethies.
You think you know who the killer is? What have you got?
Well, this is it.
Bigby?
Crane murdered Lily.
What?
I followed a lead to this shithole motel, the Open Arms. Crane had a room there, and he's been taking prostitutes, or at the very least Lily, and making her look like you while he was, you know. The bed was covered in blood. I know it was him.
This is... I don't even know what to say right now. I really don't...
Disgusting.
I'm just trying everything I can right now. To not picture it.
I'm sorry, Snow. And I'm sorry I had to be the one to tell you.
You're sure this is what happened? This is what he's been doing? Because please, Bigby, don't confuse things. Deposing Crane would be the next step.
Crane has been taking photos, Snow. Lots of photos.
Photos that show him...
He's been recording his visits with Lily.
God. Look... Let's go back to the business office.
Grossed out.
I doubt Crane's there at this hour, but we need to talk. And this isn't the place. Snow? Narissa? What is it?
I'm sorry, but Holly's asking for you.
Are they starting the burn?
Yes. Everyone who spoke should really be present for this part. She's kind of distraught. You're not leaving yet, are you?
2 minutes.
Nope.
I don't mean to be,
No, I understand.
No, I get it. Take your time.
It won't take long.
See, I'm being nice! I'm being nice to him! This is like the first time ever!
How'd it go?
Oh, shit.
At the motel, did you find anything?
I did.
No?
I did. It helped a lot. Thanks.
Narissa!
Was I supposed to tell her?
Yeah, coming!
Okay. This is so creepy.
Constable, where are they up?
Oh!
Wait, easy now, girl.
Fuck.
You know how this goes. The first thing in a visit, you say, how do you do? How do you do?
I'd tell you to run, but it won't do any good. Just make it more fun for me.
What are you dreaming about? You ain't a fast enough pup to prevent me from emptying both barrels into Snow White's face over there.
What
I'm
the
still
fuck?
Hurting, you know, from our talk in the cell. And I'll be honest, I'd love nothing more than to carve a sweet poem right into your face for the suffering you've caused me. But I am a professional, and we're here for a job. We'll snip to the chase for all sakes. A little bird told us that you're fitting to go after Crane. And you see, we have an interest in that particular boy. So you leave Crane alone, and we'll leave you alone. Just take a little vacation is all.
You have 3 seconds to fuck off before this goes to a place you don't want it to.
Oh, I don't have my stopwatch on me.
These motherfuckers.
We have a deal. You leave Crane alone, and we leave you to yours. Brother?
Just don't hurt anyone, D.
That don't sound like a yes to me.
Always fuck.
Wanting to do things the fun way.
Ladies, gentlemen, invertebrates, please, rest easy. This is not...
What the hell is going on?
What's happening?
Very sorry to impose, but we only had a deal to work out with Bigby. And we're unhappy to report that things did not go as smoothly as planned.
Bigby, what is he talking about?
Never you mind that. It ain't any of your...
What deal? They want me to leave Crane alone.
Crane?
Oh, now you shouldn't have done that, old boy.
Oh, fuck.
Really? That wasn't right, telling everyone our dealings.
Oh, fuck. Oh, bitches, man!
What did I tell you? What did I say?
Holly?
You think you motherfuckers could come here uninvited? You think you could just fucking interrupt Lily's funeral?
Calm down, darling. It was just a simple business transaction.
You fucking freaks are not getting away with this.
Holly, don't move.
Calm down, Holly.
Yeah, let's spare all the fuss. It's just a dead horse.
Oh.
I'm gonna kill you!
Oh, shit!
I got it,
Stop the shotgun! Fucking stop! Q! Beat this motherfucker with a shotgun! Punch his ass! No! Oh, fuck! She's not dead, is she? That's the fucking intro. Oh, God. Skitch, I got shot in the face. It looked like I got shot in the face. Instead, I got shot in the shoulder. Holy shit. What an intro. Episode 3 of The Wolf Among Us. Ooh, kill him! Holy shit. That was just the intro. Everyone always thinks the episode's over when this comes up. Not the credits. Episode 3. A crooked mile. Woo! Oh, getting wrapped up.
I did as well as I could to take out the buckshot, but there's still some shards left embedded in your shoulder. They'll eventually worm their way out on their own, but until they do, you're gonna be sore.
Bigby, Dr. Swinehart was appointed Fabletown physician for a reason.
It's okay. There's only one thing you have to take away from all this. Take it easy.
Yeah,
don't
that's
go looking for any more
not
fights.
Gonna work.
Keep strain off your heart.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm good.
Is she?
She's fine, Bigby. I had everyone that got wounded sent home. Holly refused to let me see where she lived, so I left her and Grendel back at her bar with a dose of juniper.
Oh, they
and
both
spring
lived.
Water.
Everyone lived.
Just remember what I said. The stitches won't hold up if you continue to act like you normally do. Everything in moderation. And eat more chicken.
I'll try to.
Eat more chicken.
All right, then. Very good.
Business office. I know. I'll have to call you back. The town is starting to find out.
Well, I'll leave you two to it then. Miss White, Bigby.
Better physician, doctor guy. Ooh, damn abs. Can you put a shirt on? That's what she's gonna say.
So, to recap.
Crane watched me through the magic mirror uncover his room at the Open Arms, and then he smashed it so we couldn't use it ourselves to go after him. And we know this because Bufkin was drinking in the rafters. That about cover it?
And once he puts all the pieces back together, it'll be easy to catch Crane. So, I guess that's the plan, currently.
Just wait for the mirror?
I don't know.
There's no other leads. This is it. Just wait for the mirror.
Yeah. What the hell is going on? I don't know what the Tweedles get out of this. I don't know if Crane sent them. I don't know if... I mean, this is gonna sound crazy, but do you really think Crane did it? Everything points to him. I get it. But do you really think he killed those women? Because it's just... It's incomprehensible
to me. I'm not sure.
I'm
really not sure.
I'm as confused as you are, to be honest. I don't know. It just doesn't make sense.
He was a conniver, a coward, a liar. And I'll always hate him for that. And I'll hate him for how he held me in his thoughts. But murdering prostitutes?
Ow!
Everything okay over there?
Yes, Miss White. Just cut myself on a piece of the glass. Nothing to worry about.
I love that little
bastard.
Thanks
for tonight, by the way. That could have gone really terribly. I mean, even worse than it did.
I just feel bad for Holly, really.
Yeah. Time heals everything eventually. At least, I hope so, for her sake. Can I, ask you a question? It's kind of personal. And
I don't
want to offend you, but after tonight, it's on my mind.
Sure.
It's just, when stuff hits the fan, like it did tonight, it feels like before we came to the city. It feels kind of like home. And I've heard it said that maybe in some tiny little bottled up way deep inside, you kind of enjoy it when things go wrong. Because it gives you an excuse to just, you know, stop pretending.
I have nothing to say.
I guess it doesn't matter.
I have nothing to say to that.
Guys?
I didn't know what to say.
Have
I just.
Problem.
I'm gonna stay quiet.
I can't finish the mirror. It's missing a piece.
Oh, that motherfucker.
What do you mean, missing a piece?
Yes, it's,
Crane must have taken a shard with him.
Oh, I can't believe this.
I saw Crane pick something up after he smashed it. I'm sorry, I didn't realize what it was until now.
Well, the mirror can't work unless it's whole.
Well, that's not entirely true.
Or what, Bufkin? What? We sit around and wait until it mends itself? We have no idea how long that will take. We're just gonna have to do this the hard way.
I'm just saying, waiting is an option.
No.
What's the hard way?
The hard way.
We'll look through his things, his desk, everything. He had to have left something that tells us where he's going. He's a neat freak, but he was never that smart.
Smart enough to take a piece of the mirror.
Buffkin,
shut
up.
This ourselves. I know.
Never mind that. Come help me look.
Hey, what if he? Hey, what if he had a clue? Why don't we just? No, Buffkin, go talk to Buffkin. Talk to him. Buffkin, what were you saying, bud?
Hi,
poor little guy.
Mr. Bigby. I can still help you catch Crane, you know.
Oh, yeah?
Yes. I saw him jump on the telephone before he left. He called up somebody. He said he needed to see his witch, or that he would need to get to the witch for that, whoever that is.
His witch?
Yes, it sounded like the one he got his snow glamours from.
You didn't see anything else, did you?
No, not especially.
Look, the whole mirror thing, it's not your fault, all right?
You mean it?
Yeah, Buffkin.
I'll just see if I can do anything about this.
You do that.
Poor little guy. Yeah, his name should be Blumpkin, to be honest. All right, White.
Buffkin
Snow
says
White.
He overheard Crane call somebody before he left. Sounds like he's going to see a witch, or his witch. His glamour witch.
Wait, really? None of the 13th floor witches would allow that sort of thing. They must be somewhere in the city. It's something, at least.
Find anything?
No, but there's enough notes and stuff here to take all night. Maybe
check
anything. That stuff there.
Alright, I'll check that stuff here. I don't know what you're talking about, but... Crane's desk. Examine. Is that a big-ass hand back there? This room is filled with crazy shit. Alright, let's check. Oh, there's a key. Grab the key.
What is it?
It's the key to his room at the Open Arms.
You still haven't told me what was in there.
It doesn't matter.
I want to know. I need to know.
Oh, God.
Crane was paying Lily to live out a fantasy of him and you together. Forgive me if I spare you the details.
I keep thinking back. I keep replaying moments in my head. Interactions with him when he'd catch me in the elevator or bump into me outside. There's only so much you can repress, you know?
Snow, you couldn't have known.
No, I could have.
No, not really.
Come on, let's keep looking.
Alright, let's read these notes. What about Crane? Are there any updates on the extra funding I requested? As I explained in my last letter, the conditions here could do with some improvement. I'm seeing some unrest from the residents, and I have to admit I can see why. The farm should not be a punishment. I'm sure you're busy, but I think this should be made a priority. Best, Smith. Huh. What's this one? By Crane, I'm writing to ask again that you please send someone to fix the air conditioning in our unit. It's burning up in the apartment, and Pinocchio says his skin is splintering. I don't even know what that means, but I assume it's something gross, and I'd really like it for you to fix the air like we asked you 3 months ago. At the very least, provide us a fan in the meantime. Sincerely, Boy Blue. And the third note. Gotta be something. Mr. Crane, you said you'd pay to have the plaster redone on my building after the last incident, 204. It's falling off the fucking walls. Please fix it. I can't rent out the room as it is. And I've already been waiting for days. Not to mention you already promised me you'd send someone to fix the big crack in the glass on the front door. Well, guess what? It's worse now. Get your shit together, Mr. Toad.
Did Crane ever do any work?
Damn.
Only when Cole was around.
Alright. Didn't do shit. What an ass muncher. Ooh, let's rub the... Oh my god, let's rub it! Rub it! There's a genie in there! You guys know there's a genie in there. Oh, you can hold shift to go faster. Did I miss something? Crane's desk. What did I miss? What thought I checked everything. Did I miss something? Talk to Bufkin. Huh. Looks like there's only three things to check. What am I supposed to do? Maybe I missed something on the desk. I'm gonna look again. Oh, duh. Drawer. I didn't even look at the drawer. Gotta be some good shit in here. Oh, it's fucking. That scared the shit out of me. Oh my god, what the fuck? That scared me. There's a page ripped out.
There's a page here that was torn out.
Oh, yeah? Bufkin, do you know what was here?
It's a ring, at least. Every magical item not retained in the armory is assigned to someone in Fabletown. It must be this witch he is going to see.
Yeah, I only recently heard about this meeting. Why didn't you mention this before?
Oh.
No one asked me.
Bufkin!
What?
And I'm
hungover.
What are
you talking about?
I'm sorry.
I just told the...
He set the meeting at 2 a.m. tonight.
You didn't tell us that?
What's going on? Is the mirror fixed yet?
Bluebeard, this isn't the time.
Is the mirror fixed or isn't it? You called me
to... I called just to see if you knew where Crane could be, and that was it, okay? And I'm sorry I said anything more than that.
Well, you did, and I know. The cat's out of the bag.
So cat's out of the bag!
Or not.
Oh my god.
I tried to,
isn't
but...
your concern?
That's so funny.
No, it can't be fixed. It's missing a piece.
This is none of Bluebeard's business, Bigby.
None of my business? Crane's the murderer. He escaped. It seems he's foiled your every attempt at locating him. And now it's none of my business?
We don't know if he's the murderer.
Oh, please. Of course he is.
Look, this just isn't the time. He took a piece of the mirror, so we can't use it.
The only thing we know is that Crane's going to see a witch at 2 o'clock.
A.M. or P.M.?
A.M.
A.M.
Damn it.
Listen, Bluebeard, you're not a part of this.
I don't think you're in any position to turn away help.
Why do you even care about this?
Why? I'm invested in this enterprise we call Fabletown. Literally invested, since it's mostly my money that keeps the whole thing running. And tonight I hear that Crane has been killing fables, and there's no system in place to catch him?
Look, we know that Crane is going to see a witch, and it's to acquire a magic ring.
What's the ring?
We don't know what it does or who it's assigned to since Crane tore its page out of the book.
This farce was your ridiculous idea for a plan. I mean, who put you in charge in the first place?
Fixing the mirror was the most logical
thing. You're a secretary. He's the sheriff. And none of you were chosen to run this office. Who elected you to make these decisions?
Nobody, but that
who
doesn't...
Who elected her to spend my money?
Well, I've been doing that unofficially for years now.
Unofficially is not officially.
Snow can obviously handle this, so let's drop it.
Yeah, bitch.
Well then, excuse me for having the Commonwealth in mind.
Man, what a psycho.
All right, let's just look on the bright side. We know Crane is going to see the witch that's been supplying him black market glamours.
Thanks to me.
And that he'll be there at 2. So that gives us a few short hours to find out who it is and where they live and get them all at once.
And a few shorter hours the more you babble about it.
We haven't been the ones babbling.
2 a.m.
True.
Piece of cake.
Since Lily used the glamours, she'd have known who the witch was. And I don't think Holly's burned her things yet. It would probably have the address or a phone number or something.
And Bigby is free to go there if he likes. But I think the question you should be asking is just what do the two Tweedles know about this?
It doesn't matter what they know. After tonight, they'd never go to their office.
They're not smart enough to try and go anywhere else.
The Trip Trap is the better option to track the witch down.
Can always do both.
It has to be our focus.
Look, chances are I'll have to swing by both anyways.
No, chances are you won't have time.
I don't really care what you do. I'm going to his apartment.
What? You can't just go up there.
And why the hell not?
We already looked for the key, remember? I don't know where it is.
Then I'll pick the blasted lock. I've wasted enough time waiting for the mirror to find him.
This guy's such a douche. Damn.
You just... can't go up there alone, all right?
I've no interest in nicking his drapes, my dear, if that's what concerns you.
What concerns me is you traipsing through possible evidence.
Oh, now. It's evidence.
Bluebeard, just stay out of it, all right? You'll just mess things up further.
They can't get any more messed up.
We have to find the witch, Bluebeard, since that's where he's going.
Or the sniveling weasel chickened out. Never went anywhere. And is upstairs right now in his pitiful penthouse, crafting a fort out of couch cushions. Look, this is how a smart person would do it. So this is how we're going to do it. Wherever you go, I'll go to the other.
I don't like you going anywhere unsupervised. He's up to something. I don't know what it is, but we don't have the time to really worry about it now. Where are you gonna go, Bigby?
I don't know. I'll go where White wants me to go. What the fuck?
So you leave Crane alone, and we'll leave you alone.
I'd love to join you, but there's some business I need to attend to.
No, I'm better off dealing with things alone. I don't need sympathy and I don't need charity.
Crane's apartment, Holly's bar, or D's office. What do you guys think, stream? What do you guys think? D's office, Crane's apartment. I kind of want to go into Crane's apartment, or I don't know. I don't know which one to do. Hurry, someone make a decision for me. Hurry! I need to know! Apartment. Okay. Apartment.
I'd love to join you, but there's some business I need to attend to.
Crane's place is right here. I should check that out first.
Perfect. And I'll go to those two imbeciles' office.
Crane's penthouse number is 1903. Let me know what you find. I hope you know what you're doing.
Oh, I know. 1903. Okay. There's gotta be some shady shit in his apartment, right? Or something. Is this him? This is 1902. Let me examine it. What does it say on the door?
Snow said Crane lives in 1903.
There we go. Oh, the door is open.
Anyone in there?
This is sketch.
Crane. Damn it. Must have missed him. There's gotta be something about his witch here.
Let's see. Not a bad looking place. Look at that little douche. Oh my god.
I've never seen him that excited. Guess things have changed. Math, science, history. Tried to guess, this shit didn't work.
The Joy of Lovemaking. What a book. I gotta get myself a copy of that. Ooh, wine cabinet. Let's drink.
Same brand we found in the open arms.
What if this whole time Crane was actually a different person? Playing Crane. Ooh, a teacher pouch. What's in that?
This hasn't been used in years.
Oh. Journal? Merry Christmas, Mr. Crane. Thanks for all your...
I forgot. He used to teach in the old days.
That's terrifying. Oh, an envelope. There's gonna be weird pictures in this. Oh, money. Take it.
Crooked man. This is all I could get. I'm afraid Snow will start to notice. I'll have the rest for you next week, Ichabod Crane. What's going on here?
Confiscate it. Gotta take the money. Why not? You got a note?
My dearest Snow, I know you must be aware of my feelings towards you. Watching you work, if I am unable to control myself, it's because I love you.
What the fuck? Oh, a key. What is this key to?
Might be useful.
Yeah, it's useful. The Headless Horseman. Okay. So where do you think that key goes? That's the question. We gotta explore the rest of the house. Over here, maybe? I don't know. This is the front door. Can't see shit because of the camera angle. Gotta be some secret little panel or something.
Really?
Well, he's got a statue of himself. Is that really shocking? Wait. Oh, this is the bedroom. There we go. Don't
hey,
move.
Stay where you are.
Jack. What the fuck?
Wow. It is just unbelievable running into you here. I mean, of all the places. This weather, right? A little damp, I guess. But, you know, some people like that sort of thing.
Explain yourself. Now.
Okay. I know what it looks like. But before you go jump into conclusions, Crane pays me to water his plants when he's gone. It's a stipend. But you know I need the work. I wouldn't do it for free, right? You know me. So, anyways, now that I'm done...
Bullshit.
I don't see any plants. Hey!
Get his ass!
Okay!
You ain't going nowhere, bitch boy!
You got me. Just take it easy.
I don't like being lied to.
Okay.
I'll punch you if you lie to me again.
I heard Crane was leaving town. I figured he owed us little people a parting gift. Or just me a parting gift.
You heard?
I have my sources, okay?
What's your fucking sources?
He doesn't need any of this shit.
And you heard this from?
What does it matter? I hear things.
It matters.
What else do you want me to say? I got bills to pay. Not like Crane's gonna use any of this stuff.
Tell me, motherfucker, who your source is. Necessary. Oh shit. I can't use
my. This tortured lonely pig eater bit's gonna get old eventually. Don't you get tired of it? I mean, what are you even doing here? Are you just wandering around Crane's apartment?
I'm trying to find Crane's witch. He's supposed to be heading there.
Crane's witch? Is that why he took off? Who the fuck cares about any of that? I mean, don't you think. I don't know. Solving these murders should be your top priority?
I have reason to believe Crane might be the murderer.
Give me a fucking break. Ichabod Crane? I mean, the guy's clenched tighter than a, you know, than a... Well, I'm having difficulty coming up with something appropriately tight right now, but you get
it
what
I'm... It doesn't matter if you believe it or not. I have evidence that places him at the scene of the crime, so I'm bringing him in.
Okay, fine. You know what's best.
Damn right. I'm gonna punch you again in the face, Jack.
Well... Looks like you've got it covered. Anyway, it was really nice catching up with you. I mean that. Bigby, I believe you're, blocking the doorway there. If I could just, squeeze through.
He knows something.
You know, on second thought, it's actually funny I ran into you like this. I think I can help you out.
Go on. I'm listening.
If you're looking for Crane's witch, well... I just happen to know who she is.
Oh!
If you're interested. Information comes at a price, though.
How convenient.
Convenient for you, Sheriff. I got the info you need. This is an easy win. Let's make ourselves a deal.
I tell you about Crane's witch, and you forget you saw me here. One hand washes the other sort of thing. Wipe the whole incident under the rug.
Fine. You got a deal.
Perfect.
I agreed to it.
Tell me where I can find this witch.
Strong grip. Her name is Auntie Greenleaf. Crane's been trying to keep it under wraps for years. I'm not sure what kind of a deal he's made with her, but from what I hear, he's in pretty regular contact.
Where can I find her?
Well, you see, the thing is, I don't know where you'd find her, exactly.
You gotta be fucking kidding me.
Got a name.
A name is a good start, right? I mean, that's more than what you came in with.
Right.
I'll keep my eyes open for you. If I find anything else you might be interested in, I'll be sure to let you know. I think this arrangement can be beneficial to both of us down the line.
This fucking guy.
It was just lovely running into you, baby.
What's in the bag?
Hang on a second.
Oh, come on.
What's in this fucking bag? Glamour tube.
The white deer.
Do you always talk to yourself like that?
This motherfucker.
The witch uses the white deer on everything. It's her symbol or trademark, I guess. Figured I could sell these at the Lucky Pawn.
The Lucky Pawn?
It's one of the Crooked Man's places. I work there sometimes. When I need some stability. It's a pawn shop. Get it?
Yeah, yeah. You find any more of these?
No.
Give them to me.
What?
You know what. Hand them over.
Fucking asshole.
That it?
Bigby? Are you still here?
We're done here.
Fine by me.
Who are you talking to?
And he'll be gone.
What's he doing here?
Oh, shit.
Evening, Miss White.
Good evening. What's going on?
That's not important right now. But he did have some information about Crane's witch.
Oh, what did you find out?
Her name is Greenleaf.
Auntie Greenleaf.
But he doesn't know where we can find her.
Great. Crane's meeting her at 2 a.m.
And Snow, I found a note with some money attached. Crane has been embezzling from Fable Town.
Of course, because why half-ass being a complete sleazeball? Do you think this is tied to the murders? I mean, I guess it doesn't matter yet.
Let's just catch him first.
I honestly don't care. I just want to get the fucking guy.
Damn right.
Crane's meeting Greenleaf at 2 a.m. And we have no idea where she is.
Check the records.
We're kind of close as it is.
Wouldn't she be listed in the business office?
I've had Buffkin searching for any unauthorized witches, but so far we haven't found anything. I'll give him the name, but we don't have time to wait around. You should try Holly's. She still has all of Lily's things.
If she hasn't burned it already.
There's still Goldie's place. We know they're involved. And we know that's where Bluebeard went. Where do you want to go? We don't have much time.
We're going to Holly's. The trip
I'll
trap.
I'll go to the trip trap. See about Lily's things. I think that's our best option.
Sounds good. I'll give Buffkin the name and hope he finds something in the records.
Let me know what he comes up with.
I'll be in touch. I hope you'll do the same.
We'll catch him, Snow.
Hang on, 2
a.m.
I want to talk to you.
Uh-oh, now he's in deep shit. He's not getting out of that one. 1:15 a.m. We have 45 minutes. I don't know.
She's asleep, you fucking idiot. You didn't even give me a chance to explain.
Wait, what?
What's left to explain? Just...
You just go silent?
We're closed.
Guys, it's me, Bigby.
Hey, look, Woody, it's the sheriff.
Uh-oh. This
well,
fucking guy.
Come on in, buddy. Brent, what? He's a traveler. A weary traveler and
fuck, he's drunk as shit.
Hospitality, right?
Yeah, sure. Thanks.
I want a drink. Anybody else want a drink?
Friend, Swinehart said you shouldn't mix
you
it.
You think I give a fuck what that fucking guy says?
Uh-oh.
Or what you say?
He's high as shit. He's on something.
Brent, really, you shouldn't drink right now. You should quit while you're ahead with that stuff. I might need your help.
Holly's asleep in back, but you won't be able to wake her.
Really? The doc gave him both barmesidal ambrosia.
Oh.
Look, the deal is, if you resist going to sleep, like I am right now, it gives you a very, very, very nice high.
He's
he said that he shouldn't mix it with alcohol.
Oh, no.
Yes, he did. He certainly did. But let me tell you something. I haven't felt this good in a long time, fat boy.
Have you seen her sister's things? What wasn't burned at the funeral?
I saw her come in with something, but I didn't see where she put it.
Nope, haven't seen it. That funeral back there? That was a shitty fucking send-off for a pretty okay lady.
Yeah.
You weren't fucking there. Talking to Bigby now, okay?
Damn.
Don't say you being there help things much.
Gren, don't start nothing.
Who's starting anything? I'm not.
You think I shot up the place? It wasn't my fault.
They got away, though, didn't they?
I'm finding them. I'm gonna find them.
Whatever. It's all right. I'm too out of it to get into it. I want to clear the air. We're all in this dung heap of a fucking shit town together. We're all gonna have a toast. All of us.
Fellas, I'm here for one thing. To look through Lily's belongings and get out of here. Now,
yeah,
what?
Yeah, I know, I know. And I want to help you, okay? And I will. But first, indulge me. It'll take 2 seconds. As a show of good faith. And after, we'll all hunt and peck for Lily's shit or whatever.
Grand Bigby didn't come.
I like this guy when he's high off his ass.
I don't want to get loaded with him.
I'll drink. Oh no, did he poison me? Is that all a fucking gig?
He's dead.
All right, now help me.
Uh-oh.
Gren, the doc said you needed to rest.
How many times you fucking gonna warn me about it, huh? You're not my fucking mother, so just get off my back!
I said I was sorry, all right? I can't do anything about it. It's done.
Oh, fuck. I'm gonna separate them.
What more do you want? What else can I fucking say here?
Cut this shit out now. I don't care what it's about. Oh, I forgot. You haven't heard the news. This walking lard cake was paying Holly's sister to let him fuck her behind all of our backs. And Holly had to find out going through all of her sister's shit. What fun that must have been. Trick after trick of this fat ass and Lily.
I didn't plan for that, all right? And our thing, whatever it wasn't a big deal. It wasn't. I never fucked her when she was Snow, and I didn't know nothing about that.
No, but you knew Holly would flip out, and you knew for a damn good fucking reason.
You know what? Fuck this. I don't need this shit.
Oh yeah, that's it. Now you're teary-eyed. You were always such a lowlife. I don't know why I never realized it till now. What do you think about this fucking loser, Sheriff?
He can think whatever he wants. I don't give a shit.
No, that's okay, because I'll tell you what he thinks.
I think whatever happened was between them, and Lily is dead. So let's put this whole thing to rest, Gren.
Damn, the feels, man. This is some serious feels.
Gren.
I don't know where Lily's shit is. Check Holly's room, I don't know. But I wouldn't wake her if I were you. Sleepwalkers and trolls. I think that's the rule.
I thought you said you would help me look.
Actually, Bigby, if you'll excuse me, it seems that I'm gonna pass out. What a day. Am I right, Sheriff? What a fucking day.
Gren won't remember this. That is fucking hilarious. Ugh, I don't want to wake her. Gross. Alright, let me grab all this shit. It's by her head. Okay, don't wake her up. Let's not. I don't want cot. I'm not gonna examine the fucking cot. Wait, where's her... Oh, shit, that's her stuff? No. What? Right, let's examine everything before we wake her up. Uh-oh. You know what? Fuck it. You think I'm scared of this bitch? I'm gonna wake her ass up. Shit, there's her shit right by her hand. Of course. Oh. Oh, thanks. Appreciate it, troll. That jingle, be careful. Uh-oh.
That you, Woody? Woody? Is that you?
Yeah, sure.
Woody, bar's closed. And Lily ain't around anyway, so you can run off back to the woods, I guess.
Okay. Wait, one of the Tweedle guys is in the fucking background. Uh-oh.
Did you care about her at all? She was a nice girl.
Of course I cared. I still care.
I hope so. I hope you do.
Let's take this. What happens if she finds out it's fucking me just standing here? Being a creeper. God damn it.
I don't know why you fucking came here. There's nothing left for you to ruin. And I'm not in an entertaining mood.
Same thing. Same as the others. The book. That's what I need to read. I need to read the book.
Lily's funeral. It was just so fucked tonight. But I still wish you could have been there. I just don't know what Bigby's doing. If he cares about it. If he even gives a shit. I don't know. I don't know why he showed up.
He cares about this. About Lily. About Faith. I know he does.
You think so?
Yeah.
Well, you know him better than anybody, so... I guess I'll take your word.
She's high as fuck! Uh-oh. Don't wake her up. Don't wake her up completely.
You're getting your glamour on this day, and one of these has to be the witch. Auntie Greenleaf.
Right there. Brookhaven.
Gotcha.
Hello, this is Snow White calling. I'm looking for Bigby. Is anyone there?
Bigby, answer that phone.
There, pick up, okay?
Answer that phone.
Snow?
Oh, thank God. Tell me you found something.
I got it, Snow. Her address was here with Lily's things. It's on White Plains Avenue, 1284. It's an apartment complex.
Great.
All right, let's go. I don't want to miss him.
I'll meet you there.
Let's go get this bitch. Let's go get this dirty bitch. Coming for you, Crane.
Bigby!
You know shit's about to go down.
Yeah, me too. It's number 23. I haven't seen it yet.
We're late.
Yeah, I know.
Here we go.
This is it.
All right. How do you want to do this?
Let's just listen for a second.
Hear anything?
If anyone's in there, they're being awfully quiet.
Let's kick this fucking door down. Man mode.
Wait. What are you doing?
What does it look like?
Don't just kick it in. We don't know what's on the other side. Let's just save the last resort for last.
Fine.
Fine, okay. What would you have me do instead?
I don't know. Knock? I mean, we have no idea what's behind this.
Hello?
Oh, I'm so glad I didn't kick it.
Hi.
You woke me up.
Sorry about that.
Who are you?
Rachel, who are you?
Well, I'm the sheriff, and this is my partner.
Boss.
Oh, damn.
Nice to meet you. How do you do? Is there anything you need?
Is Auntie Greenleaf at home? Does she live here?
You mean my mom?
She ever, you know, make the nightstand levitate, turn frogs into cats, that kind of thing?
Is she a witch, dear?
No, I would never call my mommy that. She treats me all right. Is there something you want?
Snow, can you just do something here? I never have any idea what to say to these people.
You mean children? Do you mind if my friend here takes a look around? I promise we'll be quick so you can hurry back to bed.
I'd be like, fuck no, get the fuck away.
I've been here all night. Nobody's been here.
That's weird, we didn't even ask you that.
Okay, boss. I'm gonna trust your friend not to break anything. Don't get me in trouble.
I think that's actually
unusual.
Yeah, like Crane. He could still be here.
This girl is sketch. I don't think she's... This place looks... Okay, wait, there's a photo.
That your mom?
Uh-huh.
Okay, maybe I do believe it.
Let me guess. Big band or classical?
Honky-tonk.
No accounting for taste.
Honky-tonk.
It's pretty rare to see a burner like this.
Dowdy. That's how we like it.
Where's her mom? Where the hell is she? It's 2 in the morning.
Oh no, she never... That was found in the woods around Dick's Mountain. I think.
You think? Huh. You seem to know a lot. The big ass fucking tree in your house.
What
damn.
Is this?
Mommy uses that to carve her trinkets. It's from the old world.
Trinkets?
Trinkets?
Like glamours?
Not here.
There's no one here but me.
You're missing teeth. I can't trust you. I'm gonna find it.
No, it's been over all night, so...
He's just going to check. It'll only take a moment.
What's over here?
There's nothing that looks like Crane was here either.
Nothing?
See?
Huh. Let's go in this room. The closet door. Return address, the butcher.
What's that?
A package having to do with someone called the butcher. It's empty.
Wait a minute. Someone delivered.
Damn it. You
shouldn't say that.
Nothing.
Keep getting whiffs of that aftershave of his.
I do too.
Can I go to bed now?
Oh my god.
Please.
That's Ichabod. Ichabod's the child.
Is that a glamour tube?
Mommy really doesn't let anyone play with that. Trust me, I've tried. Oh, no, 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 no. Please, 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 just put that back exactly where you found it. No one is allowed to play with
that. It's all right, honey. Bigby's not going to break
it. No, you don't understand. She will freak out if she discovers I've let people in here and let them touch her stuff, okay? She checks all the time to see if things move. I don't want to get in trouble.
Snow, come on. Are you kidding? It's a glamour tube. Something's going on here.
No! Put it down! Please, don't! This isn't what you think! You gotta believe me! The guy isn't here, I promise!
It's gonna be okay, Rachel.
Please, I'm begging you. I don't wanna get in trouble.
I fucking knew it!
It hurts when you do it that fast.
Think this is a game?
Think we have time to waste on this shit? Think this is some kind of game?
No, I don't. But congratulations on winning it, if that matters to you.
All right, start explaining. And from the beginning.
Where's Crane? Speak quickly.
I ain't a fortune teller, Wolf. I have no heavenly idea where he went to.
You have to know something.
Unless you want a recipe for owl stew.
Just why in the name of everything holy are you protecting this weaselly scumbag? I mean, what on earth could he have done to deserve this kind of loyalty?
Crane could be hollow bones tomorrow, and you wouldn't see me cry a drop. But that doesn't mean I can tell you anything. You have friends, don't you? Well, I don't want Crane's friends for enemies.
If you're not protecting Crane, who are you protecting?
Get this through both of your skulls. I can't tell you. Just you being here is bad enough. There's powers at work here beyond your pathetic authority.
Whatever it is, Greenleaf, whatever it is that...
You should fear me!
Whatever horseshit you think will come back to bite you.
Oh.
You have no idea what's going on, do you?
Okay, you know what I think? I think we've been more than patient with you. This witch has been selling illegal glamours that continue to undermine everything we've built. She's harboring a fugitive that took advantage of it, and now she's resisting every attempt to make things right. I frankly don't give a crap if she's afraid for her life. We can at least make sure she never hurts us again. We're destroying the tree.
No! How dare you come in here and threaten to take from me the one thing that... That tree is ancient. It's part of the family, and it's the only thing paying for this shithole apartment. And the Fables, who can't afford the glamours from you, come to me for help. Without them, where do you think they could go?
Don't give me that. You're making money off of other people's misery. Two Fables are dead because of this crap. It's too dangerous leaving this stuff with her.
You think I like being the old woman in these stories? The men are heroes, the ladies are whores, and the old hags like me get to watch everyone they love die.
We have very different ways of handling our fate.
Very different means to handle it, too.
And I don't use it as an excuse to wreck people's lives.
Isn't there another way? She's a witch. Can't she just work for us? That way she'd be official.
You want to reward her for criminal behavior? We can't trust this woman on the 13th floor.
It doesn't matter, because I'd never do it. I'm not a house cat, and I don't play well with others.
Oh, trust me. No one would confuse you for a cuddly animal. Bigby?
Shit's getting insane.
Burn the tree.
No! Look, look, I'll tell you. Crane was here. He was here, and he left. He went to the pudding and pie to try to use my ring on the girls over there to get information.
What does the ring do?
He sets the ring to spell. You know, that it will pierce the protection around the girl's speech. He says pulling the truth out of them will prove his innocence. It won't, though. Damn thing lost its power decades ago.
Damn.
I'm sorry, but we still can't let you keep the tree. It wouldn't be right after what's happened. Bigby.
Please, Sheriff.
Gotta say with the woman.
Orders
are orders. Orders are orders, bitch. I'm burning this thing. Besides, you were missing teeth. That's fucked up.
Do you know that? I told you everything.
Wouldn't it burn down the house?
Extinguish the only measure I have in this horrid world.
Oh, she's about to freak out.
What monsters are you? What horrible, evil, villainous, warped monsters are you? I have nothing. Nothing. You took everything from me. I have nothing.
What are you talking about? You got that head from Dick's Mountain. Dick's Mountain, motherfucker. Got her ass. We're just gonna leave the apartment to fucking burn. I don't know. That's what I was told to do. Whatever, she's cranky old bitch who got two people killed. I'm not gonna give her any sympathy.
That's Crane's car.
Get in here.
No, it's nothing you need to concern yourself with. I don't think so, at least.
Shit.
Hold on. Oh, did you miss a spot? Mr. Clean, come to smash up the rest of my place.
I'll fucking do it.
I see. Come to audition, you bitch.
Oh, punch right in the fucking throat. How's that, motherfucker?
Tell me what you know now.
Uh-oh. Damn.
You can't just go in there.
I can't? Who are you gonna call, bitch?
We have a problem.
Tweedle, Tweedledee, and Tweedledum.
I know you know.
Mr. Crane, please. She can't help.
I know you know what the plan is. I won't be held accountable for this.
I can't. I can't. I'm sorry.
Oh my god, Bigby!
Wait, don't!
I didn't do anything, I promise you, I didn't do anything! These girls, the girls, they'll back me up. I just have to get the stupid ring working, that's all. They can't talk because of that spell, but once this ring gets through, I'll know what's going on and this whole thing will be over! That's all, please.
Slap him?
Completely, completely innocent. Just,
the ring won't work.
Just let me
should have slapped him.
The ring won't work. Greenleaf sold you out.
What? No. This will work. I assure you, it must. I went to you. Damn you. Come on. Please.
The fuck? Who does he think he is? The Green Lantern?
My lips are sealed.
How many years?
What?
How many years has this been going on?
Too many. But I didn't kill those women, Bigby. Please, I had nothing to do with that. Oh, God.
We found the photos of you and Lily.
I know. I just love you, Snow. I love you, and I'm sorry I'm not Prince Charming, okay? I'm sorry I didn't cheat on you and run away to Europe.
You don't love me, Crane. I know what this is. I've seen it before. It is not love.
It's fucking creepy.
Bigby? I don't think he did it.
What?
I don't think he did it either, but...
Do you really think this man murdered these women? He's not... He wouldn't be brave enough.
What do you mean? You don't think he did it at all? If you'd seen the room...
I don't need to see the room.
There's a lot he has to answer for.
There's a lot we all have to answer for.
This is
not me. I don't do shit.
You know it.
You said you found evidence of him defrauding Fabletown. Of using our money for his own ambitions. That's one thing. But don't you have doubts he's a murderer? We've both known him for so long.
I can't believe I'm hearing this. Did you see how he was acting when you showed up?
This fuck-up knows more than he's saying.
I don't.
Yes.
Bullshit.
Okay, he probably does. But there's a difference between being involved and being the guy who did it.
Okay, but if Crane didn't kill Faith and Lily... I'm sorry, but who the hell did?
This whole thing is bigger than Crane. He wouldn't have the stones to send the Tweedles after me. Somebody else is involved.
Well, shit.
I didn't intend for any of this to get so...
You've been stealing money from Fabletown for years, haven't you?
Yeah. We're not
It's Toad!
Kill you, so quit your shivering.
Ichabod Crane, you are under arrest for the misappropriation of Fabletown funds.
Damn!
You have the right to counsel, the right to depose witnesses. But as of right now, you're coming with us.
And for suspicion of murder.
No, Sheriff. You don't get to pick when to listen to me. Just because you did what I asked back at Greenleaf's doesn't give you the right to act now without restraint.
Damn!
You have to respect this office, Bigby. And you have to respect me as its leader. Starting now.
Okay, yes, ma'am. Jesus, I just throw that out there.
You have what it takes to run that office? You think I didn't make sacrifices? I made sacrifices. And you won't be in that chair 1 minute before you have to give up something you care about just so the wheels don't fall off the goddamn wagon.
I did the best I could with what I had. And the town took everything it could out of me.
Break his nose? God, I really want to.
So be it.
If I were you, I'd keep that trap of yours shut.
I had to fucking break his nose. I had to do it. Oh my god. Oh my god, I had to do it. Fucking busted his ass. Oh my god. Just cracked him one. Jesus. That might have been bad though.
Okay.
Stupid girls and preposterous schemes.
What are you saying?
Wanna get another broken fucking nose? I'll break it again. Uh-oh. Drive by. Back up. Time to go big bad wolf mode. Big bad wolf mode. Oh shit. Oh shit. Trinity from the Matrix? That's the girl that called. That's the girl that called and left a voicemail for Crane.
Look, it's recently come under our attention that you're, how shall I put this, attempting to claim what is the personal property of the Crooked Man. He's about yay high, 120 odd pounds, pissed his sheets until he was 14. Sound familiar?
I haven't told him anything.
Not now. Shh. The grown-ups are talking.
Who are you?
No. That's not how this works. How this works is you are going to walk Crane over here, like a good doggy.
It wasn't my fault.
Shut up.
Damn!
You're interfering with official Fabletown business. Step aside.
Tweedledee, what's the, that thing the Mundys call me?
What?
My nickname. You know what I'm talking about.
Bloody Mary,
that's it. Thank you. And do you know why they call me that? Because some of them, they think it's funny to have their little sleepovers and go into their little bathrooms and say my name 5 times in the mirror. They find it less funny when I actually show up and feed their lungs to the family dog. And I do that for a hobby. Like golf, to relax.
You can fuck off if you think you're getting him.
I told you he'd never just give him up.
Damn, you're gonna get just ass smacked.
Fuck it.
Oh shit! I wasn't ready! wasn't fucking ready!
Bigby?
You, rage mode! Rage mode! Come on! You! Stop that shit! Oh my god, I'm gonna be a mean motherfucker in a second! What the fuck is happening? Do I hold it? You! Oh my god! I'm turning into the fucking Hulk! Hey motherfuckers! You again? Oh my god. Holy shit! Oh, they're fucking terrified. I would be too. It's time to play a game, boys. Holy shit! Want some? It's your turn, bitch. Throw him at her. Holy shit. Hey, motherfucker, you want some more? Oh my god. Kill him. Oh, fuck! No!
Oh, God, Bigby!
It was a good show, but, you know, it just didn't know when to end.
Oh, fuck! Get up! Get up, Bigby!
You know,
you... What the fuck? I paused it. No, come on, spam Q. Come on. I'm smashing this bitch. I'm smashing it so fucking hard. That's what he said about her. Come on, cursing it.
Just take him, okay? Take Crane. Just stop, please.
Yeah, I don't know.
Snow, stay out of this.
Yeah. Oh, he's in the car? This motherfucker's watching!
The good man says it's okay with him. Hello, Ichabod. Got a stomach ache?
I took a few shots. That fucking axe is terrifying.
I mean, look at his face. Couldn't stick a pig if his life depended.
Her hand isn't even large enough to hold that thing. That's what he said. That's what they said.
Not like your boyfriend.
Oh, my balls! Oh, shit, she broke my arm!
A beautiful relationship with you guys. Really, I mean it. I'm just... Out with the old, in with the new. Long live the queen.
What a fucking psycho bitch.
See you around.
She saw it all. Oh, that arm, that bone. Oh, the bone. Jesus Christ, that's the end. Holy shit, that ending.
He's lucky to be alive. And he won't be next time if he keeps going like this.
This is getting worse by the minute. We don't have time to sit around and wait for their next move.
I'll get things under control.
Woody, I'm not gonna tell you again.
Back off, dog. This doesn't concern you.
What'd you want to talk about?
I just wanted to, about last night.
When people hear what you did to Dom, they're going to think you've gone back to your old ways.
He had it coming.
Don't hold out on me, Jack. You've always got some angle.
Not this time. I know when a mark's not worth the trouble. Do you?
Don't make me come down there to deal with you. I don't want it. You don't want it. Then again, you don't have much choice at this point, do you?
Holy shit! Damn it, I want the new episode already! Can you interrupt Snow's eulogy? You and 83.2% of players decided not to interrupt Snow. See? There we go. What place did you investigate first? 44%. I did the apartment, which is 33%. Did you make a deal with Jack? You and 67% of players decided to make a deal. Did you burn Greenleaf's tree? You and 15.9% of players. Am I an asshole? Am I an asshole for doing that? I guess so. 46.7% of players killed Tweedledum. Jesus. Did you burn? I guess nobody wanted to burn the tree. I guess I'm a bad guy for that. Jesus. Well, thank you guys for watching episode 3 of The Wolf Among Us. Episode 4 is not out yet, but it will be shortly. If you watch this on YouTube, be sure to give it a like if you enjoyed. And I will see you guys next time. If you guys are watching the stream, stay tuned. We're going to move on to some South Park, The Stick of Truth. By the way, Facebook and Twitter's down below. Check it out.